They're so tan. Hi.
Hey, what's up?
Hi, guys. Welcome back to my channel, and welcome back to me. To us.
And to me.
And to Bradley. I haven't put up a video in like a month, and I'm sorry about that, but I took some time off to get married. This is my husband! And then we went on a very long honeymoon, which I should have a vlog up soon if I can make sense of our random clips. And then when I got back, I got sick, so I apologize for the coughing and sniffles that will happen in this video, but I wanted this to be the first thing that I got up, because I didn't want to leave you guys hanging and be like, where was she? Or... So yeah, not all of you follow me on Instagram and Twitter and all that. And
you don't?
If you should.
You should.
You should. But if you missed it, I got married. I know that I've talked about getting married a lot, but I didn't say when.
We got married. I got married too.
On September 22nd, 2018.
Yep.
It was a great day, and I asked you guys on Instagram if you had any questions.
Ugh,
shut up. I did do it twice. Which, if you follow me on Instagram, you know. I lost the first round. I didn't know it didn't last more than 24 hours.
Even though I warned you, it might go away.
Well, whatever. I put it up again, and you guys.
First rule of a marriage. The groom is always right.
That is not true. So we're just gonna pretty much talk about our wedding. So let's start with like the frequently asked questions. Number one, I got a lot of questions about the dress, which I'm sorry this doesn't concern you. The designer was Lazaro. It was the third dress I tried on, which I've talked about that before, but I only tried on three. I put on the gown that I wore. I started sobbing, and my sister-in-law was like, you're not gonna have that moment again. And so I ordered it. A lot of people
I didn't know what it looked like until the day.
Did you like it?
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
It's pretty great.
A lot of people were asking if it was custom made. No, I did make my own straps, but other than that, it was a Lazaro dress. Lazaro, I don't know if it's a he or she, they make a lot of really pretty sparkly fabrics. So if that's what you're into, I would highly suggest checking them out. I didn't know anything about them until I bought the dress, and then I looked them up on Instagram.
Did you know you wanted sparkly?
No, we walked into the shop, and my dress they had on display, and I thought, how cool would it be to sparkle? Because, like, I love glitter. I've got glitter nails right now. It's the greatest wedding dress I've ever seen, TBH. I mean, I'm biased.
Yes, you are.
But, like, now I see wedding dresses, and I'm like, no, mine is better.
Okay.
A lot of people asked how we picked that as our venue, which the venue was Castle Green in Pasadena, and it was the only venue we looked at.
One and done. Doing research online before, which we weren't even engaged yet, and I was already looking at places I liked. I had like a list of like, I don't know, six or seven places.
We both looked on the Knot, I think.
Yes.
And we both made our own separate list, and randomly Castle Green was at the top of both of our lists. So that's the first place we went to see, and
it was like 2 or 3 weeks after the engagement. We're like, we were so excited to start planning the wedding. Like, let's just go see the venue. Like, well, that's the big one.
And that was another question, was did we intentionally pick the first day of fall? I knew I wanted to get married in the fall because I really wanted to incorporate Halloween and pumpkins into our wedding. I didn't want to do October because our like anniversary of when we started dating is in September, so I wanted it to be in September so it could be like 5 years or six, it'll be 6 years dating, 1 year married.
Mm-hmm.
And plus I love October anyway. Let's add some fun to another month. So I was like, let's do September. And we wanted the 29th, but once we fell in love with the venue, they didn't have the 29th. They were like,
I was like, that's over a year away. What do you mean you're booked for that?
But it's a good thing because it turns out a lot of our friends had other weddings to go to on the 29th.
Right, it was a very popular week.
Yeah, it was.
I knew a lot of people got married in the last
week. It's still been popular wedding weekends.
Yeah.
Everybody's copying me getting married in the fall.
But we did it first.
I invented it.
How did we decide on Castle Green?
We just loved it. I don't know. We both felt silly for wanting to book the first place that we saw, but everybody we were talking to who were already married were like, why trouble yourself with more decisions when you both love it? Even though we felt silly, we booked it, and then we never looked back.
We knew we didn't want a hotel wedding. We didn't want a country club wedding. We wanted, I don't even know what, but Castle Green had like the perfect, it's a 120-year-old hotel. Now it's privately owned condominiums, and we had access of like the grounds and the entire first floor. And so like cocktail hour was in the lobby, and there was a ballroom for us to use. And it's just like the perfect element of throwback. The hotel itself just like had this perfect vibe to it, and haunted. So yeah, some like we fell in every time we would go, like every few months to like go with the florist or go with the coordinator or something. Every time we would be like stressed about like, we're not sure about like this or that, but we'd go and we love the venue so much. Yeah. And like,
reassured us every time.
You could get married there in shorts with like Taco Bell or something, and like the wedding would be incredible because Castle Green was beautiful.
Yeah. We went to go see it 2 weeks after getting engaged because we knew we wanted a fall wedding, and I was afraid of not securing the date. Yeah. That's how that tied in.
Yeah.
but now I have nowhere to go from there. So, and yeah, people asked, did we intentionally choose the first day of fall? I didn't know that. To be honest, no. Like, for like a week, I was bummed that we didn't get the 29th because I wanted it as close to October as possible. But then my mom, I think, told me, like, that's the first day of fall. And I was like, oh, that is amazing.
Yeah.
And of course, actually in California, it is fall-ish now. It's been chilly outside.
It's better now.
We had a pretty hot wedding day.
It was warm, but it was every wedding at this venue is at 5, and they plan it that way because the entire grounds is shaded. And so, like, it was, it's nice, it's cool.
Like, the ceremony itself was great, but us taking photos for 3 hours.
At 2 o'clock, and it was 90 degrees.
Woo! My butt crack was sweating. A lot of questions about, did I have a wedding planner? No. But I'm a very specific type of person, and tying this in, a lot of people asked, did anything go wrong? No. Nothing went wrong, and everybody, and I feel like I might jinx like the video or something saying that, because like I thought the wedding day went so well that something has to go wrong with the pictures or video, and we got the pictures back and they're amazing, so now I'm like, oh my god, the video is gonna be corrupt. I don't know, but nothing went wrong. Everybody told us this entire time, well, you can't control everything, something's gonna go wrong. I controlled it was great.
Yeah, why would anything go wrong when I planned everything. Like, yes, something could happen. Like, the DJ got lost and is like, you know, something like that. But besides,
even if that happened, like, I had backup situations in my head. Like, the DJ got lost, like, we have it on your iPad.
Yep.
Pod, we'll find speakers. Whatever. I'm a very do-it-yourself, if you want it done right type of person, and that's what I did. We knew exactly what we wanted, so I wanted to do it. And that's my personality. I like to plan things. I like to plan parties. It was very stressful, so if you are the type of person that just like, nope, give it over to wedding planner. Be detailed.
But
you
still
have
to make the decisions. That was the hardest part. With the power of the internet now, not to belittle anyone out there who is a wedding planner, but like with the internet, you're like, I want a photographer in Los Angeles for this price. And you immediately get a list, as opposed to 30 years ago, you needed a wedding planner who had those kind of contacts. Decisions is the hardest thing. And I guess a wedding planner like narrows it down for you, like these two and three, but like, picking a photographer and you're just like looking at photos on the internet, like, I know whoever I hire, they will be great, but making that one decision, I'm just like, I don't know.
We did have a day of coordinator because our venue had made us have one, which thank God we did, because
I didn't think we needed one. You need one.
Yeah.
So if you're getting married, have a day of coordinator, just because like the two of you are busy taking photos and you know you're not
getting ready and just trying to relax and enjoy your day.
And we're controlling people. We would have loved to like be inside to see the catering company setting up to like, no, actually we wish we would have it, but you're too busy doing photos or doing this, you know. It's,
if you follow or watch Nikki Philippi, you know Slaylissa, I hired Melissa, Nikki Philippi's personal assistant.
What?
That's what they call her, Slaylissa.
Why?
She slays the game.
Okay.
Which I'm sure you can agree.
She was incredible. I've never called her Slaylissa, but
I wish I would have told you that. But I've worked with like Nikki on a couple different projects and Melissa's been there, and when they told me I needed a coordinator, she was the only one I could think of that would get it done like me or better. So she was incredible.
The best, like,
she made our day.
Yeah.
Like, she was incredible. So thanks, Melissa. She watches. You're the best. A lot of questions were the first dance songs. You and I danced to
Wow. Yes.
So Close by John McLaughlin. It's from, a lot of people think it's from World of Color, which it is, but it's from Enchanted.
It being a World of Color is how it became our first dance song.
Yes, we love that song, and it's a beautiful song, and we like that it's like subtly Disney, but it's not like in your face. Disney, like, we didn't dance to Beauty and the Beast.
We could have.
Which we should have.
You're in a wedding dress, but you would have come back in, like, in that yellow thing.
Yeah.
And
same dress,
just
in yellow. Somebody asked, was my dress inspired by Enchanted? And it was no. And that song was already picked out, but I did like that when I saw the dress.
Does it look like the one in Enchanted?
Yeah, I mean, it's missing the sleeve. So yeah, we danced to that. Me and my dad danced to The Wonder of You by Elvis, and you and your mom danced to
Return to Pooh Corner by Kenny Loggins.
A lot of people asked, what are some of the, like, hints or subtle Disney things we threw in?
Everybody thought we were going to get married at Disneyland, we were going to have the carriage, blah, blah, blah. I get it, we're Disney fans, but like,
That's not what either of us wanted.
Do we seem that crazy?
Although, when I was looking at pictures of my dress, I saw this other bitch in my dress, and they got married at Epcot, and I was like, whoa.
Whoa.
That would have been bitchin'. Their pictures are around World Showcase.
That's incredible. But I wanted to get married here. The most important thing to me was the Los Angeles wedding because my entire family and friends are here.
Yeah, we both grew up here. It made sense here. And I forgot what we're talking about.
Disney.
It's been a long time since I filmed. Oh, Disney subtle hints. Well, and there's a lot of questions about this, but we'll just plug it in now. My biggest subtle Disney hint was my bouquet was made up of only and all flowers that were in the golden afternoon scene from Alice in Wonderland.
The people on the Instagram that got that right, you're a
no, wow. That means we did it right.
That's impressive.
I had the idea, I mean, like, I love flowers and I didn't want to chintz out on flowers. I wanted a lot of flowers. And I knew who I wanted to be my florist. It was Best Day Ever Floral Design. Her name is Annie. She's incredible. Worth every penny. And so she sent me like this questionnaire of like, what flowers do you like? What do you not like? And I was just like, I don't freaking know. And I don't know how I got the idea, but I got the idea of having just the golden afternoon scene in my hand. And I started crying, which is really...
I didn't know that. You posted that the other day online.
No, I cried.
Where was I?
I don't know. I was sitting in the office. I remember it. I'm sure you were home.
Jeez.
I started crying and I liked the idea of how colorful it would be. And I knew it would probably be a bit of a harder thing to make it tie in with the rest of the wedding. But I also didn't care. Our photos of just the two of us and him in all black, me in white, and then my colorful ass bouquet, like, nailed it.
I don't know how you... knew that. It's perfect.
I have these visions.
After seeing that, I think like every bride and groom should do that. Every guy should be in like a tux, her in a white wedding dress, and that pop of color.
I mean, that's not what everybody wants. It's looking through photographers, a lot of people's photos were so muted and so... I like color. I like saturation. I like reds and... or like I just... that's what I like visually, so that's... I guess why I was down. And a lot of people, like, and I've talked about this in some videos, asked like our wedding colors. They were technically orange and dark blue, but that sounded so disgusting to say out loud. But the way it came together...
I don't even
together,
know what that means though. Where was your color scheme? Where is the color scheme?
On the bridesmaids, we're in dark blue. Okay. Our flowers were like orange and blue. We had the pumpkins.
Yeah.
So that
was our
color
scheme. But like the tablecloths weren't
that.
Well,
we kind of had a shift. Like we had two different color schemes.
Castle Green itself is so decorated and polished that that's what I was excited for. Like you don't need a color scheme, blah, blah, blah.
I wanted to mention
it's already perfect.
The lot, like the saloon area of it, or like... the lobby, is that what it's called?
Both, why, yeah.
It's very, like, Haunted Mansion meets Main Street, so that was very us, and it didn't need to be touched. And I'll try it, we don't really have a lot of photos, but I'll insert some, like, cocktail photos so you can kind of get the vibe. We were talking about Disney hints,
yeah.
And we are here. Yeah, so my bouquet was my number one subtle Disney hint. Nobody knew it really going down the aisle either, except, like, my best friends and my family. I don't even think your family knew.
No.
Yeah, I didn't really tell anybody. And I, like, wanted to tell you guys that early on, but I was so worried that a lot of it wasn't going to be able to happen. And a lot of you asked, am I going to be able to preserve it? Yes, because most of it was fake. Because my florist was like, a lot of these aren't in season, but I have a fake flower guy, and you won't even be able to tell. And I was like, okay. And the first thing she handed it to me, she's like, can you tell which ones are fake? And I was like, no, and I don't care. It looks great. Subtle Disney hints.
Music.
Music. We had a pianist play for the ceremony and then come into the, I want to call it a saloon, I don't know why, to the lobby for cocktail hour, and that's where we had a lot of...
We were seeing the venue and there was a grand piano inside and I was like, yes, yeah. He's going to play before as people are coming in, he's going to play during the ceremony, he's coming in for cocktail hour. And I don't think it was like all supposed to be Disney music, but kind of like... in like the themes and styles of what the music would be. I was like, cocktail hour, I want it, you know, like jazzy.
Plus the venue, like that's what made sense.
Yeah.
Like jazzy, like songs like Everybody Wants to Be a Cat from the Aristocats.
Cruella de Vil. Yeah, he's a tramp and stuff like, I wasn't even trying for it to like be all Disney, but a lot of Disney songs fit in well there.
Not things like Be Our Guest or like the most obvious
Beyond the
choices.
Sea by Bobby Darin, but like everybody knows that from Finding Nemo now. And If I Didn't Have You from Monsters, Inc. Like, it's kind of like fun stuff like that.
We spent a lot of time on YouTube, like, looking up covers. That was a Disney hint. And then we had a hidden Mickey made of pumpkins. Nobody said anything about it.
Where was it?
I didn't get a picture of it. It was somewhere in cocktail art. I didn't even see it.
I didn't even know.
So.
But pre-ceremony had, like, Whole New World, Bella Notte.
At Last I See the Light.
I see the light.
That was too long of a sentence for that.
At last I see the light. You just say the entire verse. Why
and
don't
at
you?
Last I see the light. Wait, a lot of people are asking what was our favorite part. I don't know. Whole day was great.
Somebody at my work asked me the other day. She asked me before the wedding, what's your favorite part going to be? And I said, the music. That cocktail hour music, it's going to be great. And then I didn't get to hear any of it. Well,
I don't know why you thought you would.
Yeah, I had a different idea of what happened on the
night. We did all of our... That's another big question. Do we do a first look? Yes, we did. We were both very against it at first, but then my brother talked us into it because he got married 2 years ago and they did a first look. And we did all of the family photos before the ceremony, and it was great to be done after that. And I heard him, my sister-in-law's brother-in-law, and somebody else talking about it, and all of them said it was their favorite part of their whole wedding day. And that kind of made me like, that is really nice to be just the two of you with the photographer, the videographer, and personally for me, and I think it did help. I would have been sobbing down that aisle if I hadn't seen you already. So for me, it was like, I am trying to help myself out here with crying, which I think
also you go to weddings, and if they do photos after, like they see each other the first time coming down the aisle, they're doing photos during cocktail hour, and you're at cocktail hour, like, excited to see these people you just saw get married, but they're outside for an hour and a half taking photos, and that's not what we wanted. We planned all this music and the bar and these people we were so excited to see that we wanted to be at cocktail hour to be with everyone.
Yeah, so
first look wasn't my favorite part. Is that rude?
Yeah. Like, what was your favorite part?
Dance party.
Okay, we got married, and your favorite part is the dance party?
Hell yeah, that dance party, yeah. So yeah, this girl at my work asked me what was the best part, and I was after the wedding, and I said it was the dance party. I didn't get to hear any of my live music, but Amy surprised me with professional recordings, the pianist set for us, that we'll have those memories forever, which is perfect. But our dance party at our wedding was unlike any other wedding.
I learned how to use GarageBand. I'm a very controlling, hands-on person, and music means a lot to both of us. People thought I was insane for doing this, but I really don't care. It was also very stress-relieving for me. But we put the music in an order that we wanted, and then we made the transitions ourselves. We still hired a DJ because you need somebody to run the night and do the entrances, and it's time for cake, and yada yada yada.
But like, it was too much that like, we couldn't just make the playlist. Like, here's the playlist. If he hit shuffle and Treasure plays first, my favorite song, I'm not ready for that yet. I need Treasure to happen like an hour in when I'm at that hype. And so it was so much fun to, you know, where are we at in the wedding? Like, ooh, you know, it's kind of like later in the wedding, people have had some drinks. Like, we can throw in
Sloppy Hours.
Man, I Feel Like a Woman by Shania Twain, and everybody will lose their mind over that.
A lot of people ask me to put it on Spotify. I don't have a Spotify. I could make maybe an iTunes or Apple Music playlist. But else, it wouldn't be the same because I physically made tracks.
Yeah. Like, Rock Your Body, JT, great song. Touch Long. So we would, you know, like after that second chorus, move on to the next song.
I nailed it. And I'm happy about it. It didn't fly by in my mind. I feel like a lot of the, like, Cocktail Hour flew by. I was like, they came to get us for like our sunset photos, and I was like, I've been in here for 15 minutes. He's like, oh, no, you've been in here for 45. I was like, oh, okay, it's time to go then. But the dance party portion was my favorite as well.
Yeah.
I just, my playlist didn't fail, and I knew it wouldn't. I knew my
And that's
audience.
When things were, like, first look was great, but I think I was just, like, so pent up and emotional.
The day is a lot, and it's, he was alone for most of the day because everybody was with me. We had an amazing, like, bridal guest house situation at the Langham, which is beautiful. You should get married there or stay there. But, like, it's just, like, a lot in one day, and me and Bradley are each other's best friends, and I don't know. We were gonna spend the night before separated, but we couldn't do it. And I'm a superstitious person, and we did a couple of things, like, not traditional, that I'm like, oh my god, we're gonna get divorced. And the photographers had us stand there for like 5 minutes where I could see the back of him, and he was facing, not seeing me, and they were just taking pictures, and I was just like, oh my god, I just turn around, I just want to see you.
The first look was just like such a relief to see you, because it's our wedding day and I want to be together with you, and I spend half the day apart from you, that it was like, it was such a relief to see, well, I mean, damn that dress, but also to be like, okay, we're together. Let's start
it was,
our
yeah,
day.
Yeah, it was like, okay, I mean, getting ready was a long process. That was like, okay, let's kick this shit off. Oh, a lot of people asking about the cake and the food. The food was Stonefire.
Oh, yeah.
Which, if you've had Stonefire, you might think that's trashy of me. I don't give it crap.
And also, I wanted a venue that was bring your own catering and bring your own booze, because we saved a lot of money on that.
Yes.
And Stonefire, we love Stonefire, so we got best
of
both worlds.
I love Stonefire. Let me just give you a rundown. We had lemon garlic chicken, barbecue tri-tip, mac and cheese, mashed potatoes, marinara pasta, pesto pasta, Caesar salad, garden salad, hella breadsticks, hella ranch, hella barbecue sauce. It was. And it was incredible. That was the food. And then the cake, a lot of people asked what was one thing you had to have. I had to have a Hanson's cake. If you've had one, you get it. And so our cake, we had two flavors. We had, what I needed was just the vanilla with, they have some sort of strawberry buttercream filling. I don't know. It's literally incredible. And then we got a second layer or flavor, which was marble cake with buttercream filling with mini chocolate chips in it, which we didn't have any on the...
I had half. I had half a slice of marble.
I had the bite you shoved in my face, and that wasn't even the strawberry one.
We were too busy dancing.
We cut the... I was supposed to save the top of the cake for next year, but we cut half of it, and we had that for a few days. And
I mean, also, we're not going to eat all that next year.
Yeah, no.
And also, let's enjoy it while it's good now.
I didn't have room for that in my freezer, to be honest. So, yeah, that was the food and the cake. Somebody asked, was Luna there? Unfortunately, there were no dogs.
No, sorry.
Or children.
We could have had dogs. We couldn't have children.
Yeah, they had stricter rules on children than dogs, but somebody asked if we're, like, slightly relieved that it's over. Yes. I miss the actual day. I miss maybe the anticipation of, like, I'm getting married next week. But I don't miss the stress of...
It was a lot to do.
A lot to do, a lot of opinions from other people. You just, sometimes you feel like you're letting other people down by trying to do what you want to do. And I don't miss that aspect of it. And I was over making decisions. I was over making any decisions.
By the end, Amy turned to me and said, I do it. I can't.
Yeah, I was over it. I say this all the time. I'm a Libra. I'm not good at making decisions.
I'm an Aries. I don't know what that means.
Libra and Aries are the perfect match.
Okay, great. We did a high five after our first look, and the photographer was like, that was great.
It.
Do that again. I need it.
It's like, ugh, God, get it the first time. Remember when we got married?
Yeah, we did. I miss it.
I agree.
Bad. I miss the day. You're right. You spend a year. You spend so much time. You do so much planning for 8 hours.
Yeah.
And it goes by. But the photos look great.
The photos are incredible. And if you're not following both of us on Instagram, you've only shared two. I've shared like 9. And I will continue to share. Questions about the wedding party. We just had siblings. So I had my sister, his sister, and my sister-in-law. And he had my brother and his brother. What would you have done differently if you could? Nothing.
Nothing. It was great.
Nailed it. Somebody said, did a fan try and crash any pre-wedding events? And somebody asked, why did I keep the date a secret? I feel like I made it more dramatic by keeping it a secret when I mean, I don't know. I just didn't want any wedding crashers. Not even from, like, me. My father is an LA local celeb, and some questionable things happened this last year that just made me a little bit nervous. And I just didn't want to have to deal with something like that. Although, we were taking photos, and if this was you, let us know. We were taking photos, and somebody walked by and yelled, Amy and Bradley! And we didn't see them. And it was too early for it to be any of our wedding guests, and nobody tried to get in. Luckily, the venue came with, like, security, so they were checking people in. Nobody tried to crash it, but we did have that moment of somebody yelling our names, and I was like, oh, they found us. That is why I kept it a secret. And just because, I don't know, privacy, you know? I don't know.
And the suspense.
Yeah, and the suspense. Weren't you excited when you saw my Instagram story?
Yeah.
Like, it's today. Sorry to be secretive. And I'm sure I'll be secretive
it's
again.
It's our day. We did what we wanted with it.
Yeah. Thanks, babe.
Yep.
Did you walk down the aisle to a special song? Yes, I did. I've always wanted to walk down to Ice Dance by Danny Elfman from Edward Scissorhands. And the rest of the, like, ceremony music was all Danny Elfman, which was... nice of you to let me have. I know that's probably not your first choice, but...
I wanted to walk down to the Jurassic Park theme song.
Nope.
She wouldn't let me.
Nope.
I walked down the aisle.
He did.
Yeah.
He did.
And like, usually the groom, like, comes out, like, oh yeah, like, the groom, like, comes out a side door and stands at the front, and I was like, I'll just walk down as well and then stand at the front. It was awkward because everybody's, like, sitting, enjoying, like, company, and then, like, oh, we're starting, here he is, and I'm like, hi, yes, it's me, and everybody... gave me an applause. I was like, why clapping?
But... And I was like tucked away in this room, but I could see a little bit out of the shutters, and I saw that and I heard it and I was like, oh my God, Dad, they're clapping. It's cute.
Bradley's getting married. Yeah.
Somebody also asked, was it more emotional for, I guess, me having my best friend married us, my best friend Jordan? Yeah. To be completely honest, I hardly remember walking down the aisle. I know I went entirely too fast.
You were booking it.
I ran down the aisle, which I don't know why I did that. I just was like, Bradley, okay, let's go. I was just really concentrating on not... I didn't want to pass out, which I didn't even feel like I was going to pass out. So yeah, I mean, I was expecting to completely melt when I walked down the aisle to Bradley and Jordan, but to be honest, I ran down the aisle, and I don't think I looked at anybody but Bradley. I think we may have answered everything. Is there something that, like, we want to cover that we haven't thought of? So yeah, if you have more questions, we can do an Instagram Q&A or whatever. Just trying to think of, like, all the vendors. For videography and photography, we had Buster Brown Productions for videography and Wedding Nature Photography for the photographers, and they were incredible. Mm-hmm. The photos look amazing, all of them. We haven't gotten the video yet. A lot of people ask if I'm gonna share the video. I don't know. Maybe, probably. Like, if it comes back and I love it, it's gonna be hard not to share, but, like, I don't know. I'm pinpointing and weird about what I want to share and what I don't want to share. I don't know. Talked about the food, talked about the cake, talked about Melissa. Oh, I wanted to talk about Minted, which Minted sponsored us this entire wedding process.
Thank you, Minted.
And they're amazing. They did not sponsor. I ordered our save the date through Minted, and I fell in love that I reached out to them and I was like, hey, would you guys want to work together, do a trade situation? And they said yes, and it was the greatest trade of my life. But this was our save the date. They did my tea party, Alice in Wonderland, and I'm gonna post close-ups of these on Instagram as well, because I worked hard on all of these and they, like, made my dreams come true. Like, if you have custom designs or custom whatever, they have a special line you email and they will help you design whatever you want. And then we had Beetlejuice on our wedding invite. And Bradley drew this beautiful photo of Castle Green and we put it on the back. But yeah, I just wanted to give a shout out to Minted. They are literally incredible. I'm gonna order our thank you cards through them. I'm gonna order our Christmas cards through them. Ooh. And anything for the rest of my life that I need, I will order through Minted, because it's just the best quality. And just, like, everything I wanted, they made happen. So thank you, Minted. And if you wanna see the close-ups of them, check Instagram, because I will have posted it by then. But okay, guys, I think that might be it that we can think of. I feel like we're forgetting things now, but people ask things about the honeymoon that I didn't get to, but I guess you can watch our honeymoon vlog and find out about that. I haven't filmed in, like, literally a month.
Ooh.
Are you yawning?
Ugh.
Are you done?
Yeah.
Not done?
Apparently.
Okay, well, thank you guys for watching. We love you.
It's all downhill from here.
Yep.
We're just a married couple now.
Don't even come for us about the babies.
We're pregnant.
Nope. My God, no, we aren't. We're not pregnant. And I probably won't tell you when we are.
And if we were, yeah, it's my damn business.
Wow.
It's my damn baby.
That turned into something
else. We need a dog first.
Yeah, we do need a dog. I'm not having a baby until I have a dog. Love you guys. We'll see you in, you know, some other... whatever. Oh, I am gonna do, I think, like a what I registered for / wedding gifts haul. I'm gonna do a honeymoon haul, a Halloween lush haul.
Wow.
I got some stuff coming up.
It's fall!
It's fall! We have fall videos to do. I'll do morning and night routines and all that crap. You guys wanna see Bradley's night routine? Let us know.
Sure. Come home from work, play some video games, enjoy a beverage, and go to bed.
We don't need the video.
There it is.
But okay, guys, thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe so you can see all those videos I talked about. But we love you, and we'll see you very soon. Bye.
Goodbye.